Welcome back on my video of installing CUDA Toolkit on Ubuntu. And on this next video, I would like to demonstrate some programs compiled and running and compiled and ran on NVIDIA GPU using a CUDA Toolkit. So I have some sample programs and I made it open source on my GitHub, which is on my programming practice repository, and you can download a zip or you can download with Git. And some CUDA sample program is on this one. Okay, need to open a terminal or shortcut. Git clone my repository. Okay, so here it is, CUDA, and for example, let's try C. So, okay, let's open some program. This is a sample C program that is written in C. This is a sample matrix addition program which is written in C. So you can just write them, and maybe it'll take some time to explain all of this. So this is, for example, the factor add addition, which is to add all the array of C, add the array of A and B into the C array. And this is the method, the declaration of the variable, set the size on the memory, on the RAM for the variable, and for this one set, okay, for this one from I, okay, set an incremental of A and B and keep C into 0. So we set just some, not random, but for me it's a random, but just set some variable for all A and B. And then finally, this is a function to record the time, and this is to do the factor addition itself. And after the factor addition is done, we stop the time, and then we see the time, and then finally we print the result, and then after that we free the memory on the variable A, B and C. And so let's give that a try. CD CUDA and then C, and then use a GCC compiler. GCC, what's the name? Okay, matrix addition dot C min O into matrix addition CPU. Okay, and let's try running this matrix addition underscore CPU. Okay, around, let's see, I forgot how much I set. By combining the factor of around 10,000, okay, it's no 100,400, which is 102,400. which is around kilo 100 kilobyte. It took 830 seconds when using a CPU. So next, let's try running a the same program but written in GPU. So let's try using the simple one. This one. Okay. This code I got from the NVIDIA tutorial, which you can find on their website. Which the difference within my code is to change the vector add function. So first I add a global, I forgot what this thing is called, but anyway, add this global. But you can find the theory on the NVIDIA website. I add this global on the void function, and I add ABC, and then okay, this is the same, and finally I declare the block ID and the block dimension and a thread ID for the NVIDIA. So there is a theory in for this, which I'm not going to cover on this video, which this video is only for demonstration purpose. And so I'm not using a for loop, but all the factor addition of all the metrics will be distributed to each block. So not the running serial on the CPU, but running parallel on GPU. And this one is to make sure that it doesn't to make sure that it doesn't process make sure it process the right amount of vector, so it doesn't exceed the 102,400 metric size array size. And the next one that changes is this one. I define the block size and the grid size variable. Instead of using a malloc on the CUDA C program, you can use CUDA malloc manage a size and size of. So this is the difference. For this one, generating some array are the same, and here I declare the block size is 1024, and this is the grid size, which I search on some people's code, which automatically set the grid size to the optimal size. For the theory, just search yourself on the Google. And then this one is the same using the This one is the same, how to record the time. And the other difference is using the vector function. This one is written using a CPU for the CPU. This one is written for the CPU, where you add the grid size and the block size before the ABC and size variable. And then after this factor add, you do a CUDA device synchronize. And in CPU, this is how you free the memory. In the CUDA C, this is how you free the memory using a CUDA free. And now let's try compiling the matrix. Okay, compiling this GPU code in using the NVIDIA CUDA compiler. Simple but slow. Into min o that again. Okay, it's called matrix addition. Let's call simple GPU. Oh, okay. So I probably made a mistake on the environment. Yeah, I'm sorry, this one is supposed to be a CUDA bin. I made a mistake. Okay, unfortunately for my CUDA, NVIDIA CUDA compiler, I need GCC 6 and GCC 5 installed. No, any, actually, just GCC 6. Okay, unfortunately I have to set this GCC to the GCC 6 for now. Okay. Okay, this time it should work. Okay, and it's done. Now is to run the program itself. Let's see, this one took 831 milliseconds. and this one took 49 milliseconds. And so so that it's this seems 10 times faster, really. Let's just see to make sure that I didn't make a mistake here. 1.04, yeah, I guess it's 10 times faster. Because I'm using NVIDIA, where is it? I'm using a GeForce GTX 1080. Anyway, I named this code as simple but slow, which you just need to use a CUDA malloc manage, which the code manage for you, and CUDA device synchronize. This is the code that is available on the tutorial, but however, for me it's a slow code which needs some more optimization. So the more optimized code is I made it on the matrix, okay, matrix edition, matrix edition.cu. Yep, I guess so. So what is the difference between the simple CUDA code? So this one is the same. Get the global thread ID is the same. This one is replaced with this one is the same. So this thing is to make sure that it does not go out of bound. And the difference should be this one, okay. So instead of using the easier CUDA malloc manage, we do this more manually. So for the CPU, we still use the CPU A and make the CPU available and set the memory on the CPU. And we also made a GPU variable. And this is the first is to set the size of the bytes into the size of the integer variable itself. this size is defined on the very top of this script. And so instead of using CUDA malloc manage, the older way is to use a CUDA malloc, which is to define a GPU variable on the CUDA memory. On the NVIDIA GPU memory. So we have two variables, which is on the CPU variable and the GPU variable. And then after that, you need to copy the host vectors to the device. So you need to copy the generated CPU variable, the CPU variable result or value, sorry, the value into the GPU variable value. So copy the variable from the CPU to the GPU using this command. Then the bytes is the number of bytes which is defined over here. And this command is to CUDA memory copy the host CPU to the device GPU A and B. No need to do the result variable. and then this one, as usual, block size is 1204, and this one is the same. This time function is the same. This one is actually the same, but we define the GPU variable over here, and then the clock time is the same. And finally, for this, for the simple code, you just need to write CUDA device synchronize. But for the old way, you need to use a CUDA memory to CPY. Okay, is a CUDA memory from device to host. So once you got the result of the GPU, the result of the from the GPU memory, you need to transfer the GPU memory back to the CPU memory to get the result. And after that is to, of course, calculate the result. Oh no, I mean to print the result. And then you need to CUDA free the variables on the GPU memory, then free the variables on the CPU memory. And now let's try to compile. Okay, this one is 49 milliseconds. Let's see if it can be faster. If it's the same or slower, then maybe the new CUDA toolkit is actually working, because back then I tested on the older CUDA toolkit, which is CUDA toolkit 8.0, and on the older GPU card. Okay, for the C program is twice faster than using the simple code. Maybe the simple code needs some optimization. As you can see, this one is 49 milliseconds, this one is 25 milliseconds. Well, that is actually enough to prove to you that the CUDA toolkit is working. But for the simulation, let me try some other codes. Let's try the Octave code. But first I need to install Octave here. I got the octave for CUDA sample code on this website. So let's see. So this one, let's close the C programs, and now let's go for the. Okay, so this one. So now I should have Octave install. And then I should run Octave as gem for them. And then I need to configure this NV Blast dot. So I need to find the NV Blast CPU location. Okay, so that one is done. Oh no, it's not. Okay, so it's almost done. So I need to locate the lib open blast. I cannot find it. Let me search for it. Okay, I found the location of the using this command. I search in the lib folder and find NDFin Plus. It looks like it's on the user lib. This one and the open blaster SO. And that's it. So to run Octave using CUDA, this one, you need to run this command. By the way, this is the one that is running on CPU. Let's try the one running on GPU. To compare, this one is 9 seconds, this one is 5 seconds, this one number is 2, and the number that we got is this one is 300, and the number of data we got here is 900. So it shows that using CUDA, is using the GPU for Octave, is faster than using the CPU. So next, let's try on the on Phyton. Python. Oh, okay, I forgot to try on C++. Let's try on C++. This is an addition, the same matrix addition program in C++, which I convert from C, well, manually. So this one looks the same for the add function. Here I made the number of elements, which is 1,000,000 elements. And this is how I declare the variable and set the memory on the for C++. And this is to make some values on the variable I and y, which I will add the variable together. Okay, I will, this is a different, so this is a kind of different algorithm, which I will accumulate the x to y, or I just forgot what I did, but at least it's not the main discussion for this demonstration. So this one is for the timer. This is the timer start, and this is adding the x and y. Oh no, I didn't add the x to the y, but I'm adding the x and y. Okay, we'll just check later next, and stop the timer. And then here is to the max error is 0. Okay, and then for this one, check for error if this one okay, whatever. So this one is actually, I got a code from somewhere and I made it myself, and I need some time to remember this code. But if I write it in CUDA, it should be the same as the explanation on C, which I add global here, which I added global here, and then added the block thread dimension and ID. And then instead of using the for loop, I use this one. And then using the same CUDA malloc manage as in C. And then to the add function is the same as the one in C. Number of block, number of block size. Okay, and the number of elements is 1,000,000. Timer stop, timer start, and then after I finish, I do CUDA device synchronize, and then I free the memory using a CUDA free, while in CPU I use a delete. Okay, let's run this in C++. Okay, next let's do it on and on so there is no error. So this one next let's do it on CUDA or on the GPU. Okay, for this one it took 0.03 seconds. This one should took 0.0005 seconds. So it's a 100 times, around 100 times faster than using a CPU. This is 10 min minus 0.03. This one is my 10 minus on the power of minus min minus 5. Okay, so that one is the simple code, and next let's try the longer code, which is on this one. Okay, let's check. Is it that one? It should be this one. Yes, this one is another code. It's possible. Oh no, this one is the original code from the original code from the website, which it didn't work for me. So on this longer code, this one is the same. Instead of using CUDA malloc manage, okay, instead of using CUDA malloc manage, I do it manually, assigning the CPU and the GPU variables. Then after I assign the value to the CPU variables, I transfer the value to the GPU variable. Oh, hello.
Hello.
It's too cold. It's too cold.
Okay, this is the longer code, and we finish testing, and then let's try compiling it. As you can see, it's twice faster than the shorter code, than the simpler code. This one is 5 times 0.00005. This one is 0.00002. And that's the demonstration on C++. There is also, I made a code for OpenACC, but maybe not today. The next demonstration I would like to do on R. Okay, R. Okay, I need to install some library first called our benchmark to calculate the time, and gmetrix to run matrix functions on GPU. Okay, that one is successful. Next is a gmetrix. Okay. Gmetrix is not available. Okay, then I need to find another way. tinkle to compile. I'll pause the video for a moment. Okay, it should be ready. Take a look. And now we'll just run the R package. So this one I have already mixed the code using a library gmetrix and our benchmark, and then the number of items or elements, maybe 10 million, and so this one is creating a GPU objects and performing a benchmark. Oh, I didn't combine them yet. Okay, I didn't combine them yet. So I'll run them separately. Let's just run them on this machine. This one is to run on CPU, GPU benchmark sum host A, and then this one is to run on the GPU. As you can see, it is okay, not that fast. I guess it didn't run too well on R. Well, it is a bit faster at least. Anyway, that's how you run R on CUDA on R. And finally, the last one is to run CUDA on Python. Okay, this program is also a vector app program application on Python using a NumPy and a timer to calculate the time. So using this is the function definition vector app ABC, and from I to in x range a dot size. So the size of A. Really? Okay. And then this is the number of elements which I made it this much, and this is I make the AS ones, the PS ones, and the CS zeros, and then add T and B into C, and how long that it takes. And I got this code from the internet also, so let's give it a try. Okay, it's a bug in my code. This one is supposed to be N. Wait. Okay, so the new Fatten doesn't use X range anymore, but uses range. So this to do the addition, it took 7 seconds. Next, let's try using CUDA with NumPy. So we use NumPy timer, and we need to use a NumPy package. Okay, so to install NumPy, you can use the apt. It looks safe for now. Okay, looks safe. So just install. Okay, it didn't work. Oh no, it would work, but looks like I need to edit my code. Okay, so this one is the vector add function on CPU. This one is the vector add function on GPU. I need to export some library for it to be used, so I use the OS. I forgot what this is called, but anyway, I use the OS. And then for the function of adding the arrays, then I use the term factorize Okay, so this one is like the setting, this one is like setting the block dimension, thread and IDs. So 32, flow 32, flow 32, and the target is CUDA. And this one is kind of like the same in C. I just need the factor at A and B, and just return A plus B instead of using the for function. And this is my def. I need to set a library for number, which is I need lib and vvm.so. I need to search this. Okay, I found it over here. And the next one, I need the lib device. Okay, and go back to the code. This one is the same number of elements as in the CPU. This one is the same, and the difference is this one is vector at A and B and C. This one is C equals vector at A and B. And I don't know how this worked. Actually, I forgot how this worked, but I found this code on the internet as well. So let's just run it anyway. Okay, so this one it's a CUDA Toolkit 7.5. So as I told you before, installing the number using the apt package manager doesn't go well. So I need to uninstall this one. Yes. And then clean it. Is not installed, so I need it installed. The install is not here either. God, let's just search the internet. Okay, Python setup tools.
Okay, let's do it.
After that is install pip. Sorry. Pip 3. If it doesn't work, then it's pip. Okay, pip 3. Oh no, then it's correct, it's pip. Pip 3 install number. Okay, I got the wrong way of installing pip, or maybe it doesn't work for this Ubuntu. Well, I'm going to use this way now. Install Python 3 pip. Okay, I got it working for some reason using this command and using easy install pip, this one. But this is probably just my special case. It should be too hard for you, but let's just continue. Okay, I'm installing number from and now that I got number installed, let's try reinstall using pip. Let's try running this again. What's this? Okay, as you can see, it's running. Using the number GPU, it takes only 0.4 seconds, while if you use the CPU, it took 7.3 seconds. And finally, the next one is to use a PyCuda. So on PyCuda is a different way to write the factored code. Here on number, I just changed the original factored code, but on using PyCuda, I use a GPU array, which it looks simpler. The number of elements is the same, and this one I create a GPU variable A and B, and then I add A and B to C using the .get, which is a variable on GPU array, I think, or maybe not, or maybe I'm wrong. And it seems simpler here. So let's try. So I need to install the PyCuda module the same as installing number through pip. Okay, this is taking some time. Let me pause. Okay, it is successfully installed. Now let's try running PyCUDA. Okay, so it took 0.5 seconds, not that not much different from using number, and it is 10 times faster. And I think that's all for now. I've demonstrated some programming codes that runs on CUDA, and that runs on NVIDIA GPU. And thanks for watching.